Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte to start campaigning for the national and local candidates of PDP Laban on March 25. That's according to Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi. Cusi says that's also when the ruling party will bear its 11-point agenda for continuity, which includes fighting corruption and defeating communist terrorism in the country. Cusi's PDP Laban faction, endorsed by the vice presidential candidacy of Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio in January. But it was not immediately clear if the president would campaign for his daughter or if he would be present in her campaign sorties. As for a presidential bet, Duterte reiterated last week he has yet to decide whether to support anyone, saying he would like to stay neutral as much as possible. The latest now on the campaign trail, Vice President Leni Robredo is in Cavite with her running mate, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, and some members of her senatorial slate. In her speech, Robredo highlighted the dynamism and significant impact of the youth. Her supporters, who are mostly young voters, said they hope to disprove the statement of Cavite Governor John Vicrimulia, who said the 800,000-strong voters in the province are supporting Robredo's rival, Bongbong Marcos. Speaking of Marcos, he took his campaign to Sorsogon. There, he led the inauguration of the new headquarters of his party, Partido Federal ng Pilipinas. His running mate, Sara Duterte Carpio, is campaigning in Metro Manila. Meanwhile, presidential aspirant and Manila Mayor Isko Moreno woos voters in Isabela. He is joined by members of his senatorial slate and his running mate, Dr. Willie Ong. Ong asserts the campaign still has his full support, despite other groups endorsing Moreno along with vice presidential candidate Duterte. The rise of disinformation through historical revisionism should be countered with the truth. That's according to Partido Lakas ng Masa senatorial bet Luke Espiritu. He says Filipinos must continue to speak of the horrors of the Marcos regime because those who are trying to revise history have billions at their disposal.
Yung mga nabubuhay dyan na mga martial law victims, they have to come out. And they have to explain to the new generation, look, part ako ng kinulong. Part ako ng tinorture, kasama ako doon sa tinorture. Ang pamilya ko ni rape, dinasaparasido. So we have to teach our younger generation that.
Espiritu made waves on social media following his heated exchanges during a debate with fellow senatorial candidates, suspended lawyer Larry Gadon and Harry Roque. Gadon is a known Marcos supporter, while Roque, who used to fight for human rights victims during the martial law, is now running under the Senate slate of Bongbong Marcos. Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion backs calls for less work from home setup. That's after more restrictions in workplaces were eased with Metro Manila and several areas which shifted to COVID Alert Level 1. Concepcion says getting employees back to their workplaces will be crucial in improving the country's economic performance.
Maraming pang ibang negosyo ay mabubuhay ulit kasi pumap na, may mobility na tayo dito kaysa nasa bahay lang sila at wala silang ginagastos. No? Siyempre may savings sila dyan pero yung economy, it will not be able to increase no? in momentum if everybody is at home.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Labor Department calls for fair treatment for employees who choose to work remotely. It reminds employers working from home is allowed under the telecommuting law. The agency also stresses the need for formal agreements between employers and workers if a hybrid work setup will be pursued.
Tandaan na po natin, mababa na rin po ang risk ngayon kasi ang kaso ay bumababa. Pwede na po silang bumalik. Pero yung mga talagang pwede naman, at yung trabaho nila ay pwedeng gawin sa home. Alam at nakikita naman yun ng employer, pwede na ho silang mag-start ng agreement. para lang ho na-formalize itong work from home agreement and arrangements po nila.
The Philippine government's debt hits over 12 trillion pesos as of end January. That's 2.6% higher from December. From December 2021's 11.7 trillion pesos, nearly 70% were domestic borrowings, while the rest was sourced externally. The Philippine government has been borrowing heavily in the last 2 years to fund its pandemic response. But economic managers say the country's debt level remains manageable. Philippine inflation unchanged in February despite rising oil prices. The consumer price index again came in at 3% within the Philippine Central Bank's forecast and government's 2-4% target range. BSP Governor Benjamin Diokno earlier said inflation may remain within target as long as the price of Dubai crude does not go above $95 per barrel. But he admits recent increases in global oil prices due to the conflict between Russia and Ukraine have raised global and domestic macroeconomic uncertainty over the near term.